Welcome to the second episode of Hip Hop Walkthroughs. In this episode, I'll be demonstrating how I recreated the instrumental for Suit and Tie by Justin Timberlake, featuring Jay-Z, produced by Timbaland. Suit and Tie is the first single off Justin Timberlake's album, 2020 Experience, that'll be released March 19th. This walkthrough will feature two sections of the beat, the intro, which is the slowed down and kind of chopped and screwed part, and the verse slash chorus. First things first, let's take a look at the source material. The sample used in Suit and Tie is by a group named Sly, Slick, and Wicked, and the record is called Show Nuff. However, instead of directly sampling the song, they decided to replay it with live instruments. For this video, I'll be using a loop of the sample and then adding in some instrumentation. So let's take a listen to the material. What they did for the track was take this loop, and repeat it three times, and then play this loop, to complete the four bar loop. As you can hear, the tempo for Suit and Tie is much faster, so after some serious work time stretching the sample, I got it to the right tempo. When you time stretch an audio file, you end up with sonic artifacts, which is unwanted material that is left after editing a file. Even with the technology of today, manipulating a sound heavily will degrade the quality. I imported the samples into the NNXT to trigger them. Once I found my start and end points, I recorded a four-bar loop. Verse repeats this loop again, and then in the last measure adds in a horn section. I decided to sample the horns directly from the record and add that into the verse. Now time to program the drums. First up is the kick drum. The pattern for it is pretty simple. The snare on the record sounds very similar to an 808 snare, so I decided to use the Kong module in order to create a snare. On pad 1, you can see the snare drum module. This module allows you to tweak settings like pitch, decay, and noise. I layered in another snare with this module at a lower pitch, as well as one more snare. Last from the drums are the hi-hats. There's a few layers here. First, I have a couple of live hi-hats playing 16th notes. And then I have a couple of open hi-hats coming in on the upbeat. To transition from the verse to the chorus, Timbaland adds in a tom-tom. I chose an 808 tom to replicate it and added some delay and reverb to it. For the chorus, the major change is how the sample is played. Instead of the first loop repeating three times, it repeats twice, with the second loop repeating twice as well. After the first eight bars, there's a horn section playing a riff. Since it's not isolated, I had to replay it with reason. I used a sax section and a brass patch with trombones and trumpets. Now let's take a look at how I recreated the intro. I had to go back to SoundForge and do some pitch shifting. The sample is going to be pitched down 12 semitones in order to get the effect. Also, I exported a loop of the hi-hats that I recorded in Reason so that I could pitch shift them too. And also, I had to change the pitch of the horn riff from the record. I decided to mix this session in Sonar, my DAW or digital audio workstation of choice. As you can see, I have my different tracks split so I have as much control as possible. This is where all the pieces come together in order to make the intro. So first I have the samples that I edited in SoundForge on their own tracks, and then I have a kick and snare that I programmed in Reason. When I sync all of that up in Sonar, I come up with this. Thanks for watching Hip Hop Walkthroughs. To stream or download this track, check the description box for a link. Please subscribe to my channel and visit my blog to receive all updates from Sure Shot Media.